Late on the night of August 21st, just before midnight, an unexpected earthquake struck one of the most treacherous stretches of ocean for ships to pass through, the Drake Passage. This quake was a major one, at first being registered as a magnitude 8.0 before being later revised downwards to a still large magnitude 7.5. While the strongest shaking thankfully occurred far away from any patches of inhabited land, this simulation shows the most intense shaking the relevant earthquake produced on the left, with the strongest shaking an inhabited area experienced on the right. Ground motion likely continued for upwards of 35 seconds, and due to the displacement of water, possibly through underwater landslides, it generated a series of tsunami waves. Precautionary alerts were sent out, but as the tsunami wave expanded outwards, it was revealed to be quite small. While measurable tsunami waves were measured as far away as Puerto Deseado, these were all between 10 and 25 centimeters or 3.9 and 9.8 inches in height. Thankfully, no damage was caused due to the remote location of the 7.5 earthquake and the underwhelming size of its associated tsunami. A few keen-eyed viewers might be wondering if this earthquake is associated with another strong earthquake that struck earlier in the year, specifically a magnitude 7.4 and 6.4 earthquake that occurred on May 2, 2025. The answer is that the latest earthquake was completely unrelated, and in fact is actually quite strange in of itself, which is the reason why I am making today's video discussing an earthquake that caused zero damage instead of covering another scientific topic. You see, generally speaking, when large magnitude earthquakes strike a section of open ocean, they almost universally occur on one of the many tectonic plate boundaries. This was the case for the two May 2nd earthquakes in the Drake Passage, but not for Thursday's quake, which struck 200 kilometers or 124 miles away from the nearest plate boundary. And this quake gets even weirder. I have first labeled a major fault line that you can easily see trending across the ocean floor for hundreds of kilometers to the southeast. I initially thought, this must be the source of the earthquake, but the moment tensor of the earthquake shows that what struck was not only a pure strike slip fault earthquake, but also that the fault which ruptured most likely trended to the north-northeast. I checked, no scientific papers are aware of a fault line that trends in that direction, nor its perpendicular, as you can see when I overlay this diagram. However, what this implied previously unknown fault line that ruptured does is it nearly parallels a lengthy fault to its west-southwest. So, problem solved, right? No. These faults shaded in pink represent a series of mid-ocean ridge spreading segments from which new molten rock rises to create new oceanic crust as the crust spreads apart. Only one issue. These spreading segments are extinct and have not produced new oceanic crust in more than 3 million years since they comprise a part of a now non-existent Phoenix plate whose outline I have colored in light green. With this being said, here are the relative motions of the tectonic plates. As you can see, the Antarctic plate portion of what was originally the Phoenix plate is experiencing a buildup of strain due to the differing motions of the Antarctic plate and the Shetland plate. These build up over time and would normally release via the creation of a different fault line vector, but instead utilize pre-existing weak points in the crust that paralleled ancient spreading segments to accommodate the release of this strain. Already, three aftershocks have occurred, which in order were a magnitude 5.1, 5.0, and 4.9. It is unlikely that any of these aftershocks, assuming they are lesser in magnitude, will cause any form of damage. So, I hope you found the discussion of this intraplate quake within a section of the Antarctic plate interesting. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Danette Koblik, for supporting my work.